What's happening, guys? My name is Crazy Cinco, and we are here today to do a little something, just to give you an idea, maybe for a TCG deck of Pokemon cards. I've been to a couple tournaments in person, in real life, and I'm just going to be showing off my deck here. Just to give you guys a little bit of an idea, maybe you guys can throw in some tweaks in the comments. And today was also the Sun and Moon pre-release. Yes, I said it. The Sun and Moon pre-release. So I'm going to be showing you guys a bit of what I got there. The 40-card deck we had to use for that. And we also got 3 extra packs for completing the tournament. So I will be opening those at the end of the video, so be sure to stick out this video until the end so you can see what we got in those. So I'm going to show you a bit of an idea for a deck. So we are going to start out with 4 copies of Combi. And now, why Combi, you might ask? Because your main attacker is going to be Vespiquen. Vespiquen, let me bring it up here to you, has 2 attacks. For one colorless, it has Intelligence Gathering, 10 damage, nothing crazy, but you draw until you have 6 cards in your hand, which can be good if you can, for some reason, only get 1 energy onto this thing. It also has Be Revenge for 20 plus 10 for each Pokemon in the discard pile. Early game, not having a whole lot of Pokemon in your discard pile, it just happens. But, you know, you let your opponent take 2 or 3 prizes and then start hitting for very hard damage. Then we also have 2 copies of Spinarak and 2 copies of Ariados. Let me bring this Ariados up to you guys. It has Poisonous Nest. Once during your turn before you attack, you may use this ability. Both active Pokemon except for grass Pokemon are now poisoned. So, you know, you're normally going to use that when you've got a Vespiquen out as your active Pokemon, so it's not going to get poisoned. Let me go ahead and move these things over so we can make more room. Let's go ahead and do that. And now, like I said, Vespiquen will be your main attacker. You probably won't have any other Pokemon to attack with, but you're also going to run 4 copies of Eevee. Now, why that, you might ask? Well, you're going to run these 3 cards here, a Jolteon, Flareon, and Vaporeon. Each of their effects say that each stage 1 Pokemon on your side of the field now has an additional water, fire, or electric typing. So with that, you can start hitting your opponents for possibly super effective damage, depending on what its weakness is. So, you know, you could be doing double damage as opposed to just regular. Or especially if you're playing against a fire-type deck, because all your main attackers are weak to fire, you get that Vaporeon out and start taking out those fire Pokemon before they can take you out. Okay, and up next we have Unknown. Its ability is Farewell Letter. Once during your turn before you attack, if this Pokemon is on your bench, you may discard this Pokemon and all cards attached to it if you do draw a card. So essentially what you do is you put that on the bench, and then you just put it right into the discard. You put it on the bench and right into the discard, draw a card, and then that starts powering up your Be Revenge, because it's every Pokemon in the discard pile, no matter how it got there. And that is all of the Pokemon in this deck. We're going to move on to the item cards. We have 4 copies of Ultra Ball. It's pretty much just a standard in every deck. Discard 2 cards from your hand and get any Pokemon. You can do that, you know, if you've got a bunch of Rayquaza EXs on the other side of the field, you need to go ahead, Ultra Ball, grab this Jolteon and start hitting for double damage. And then we have 3 copies of Trainer's Mail. Look at the top 4 cards and take any trainer card except Trainer's Mail. Again, it's pretty much a standard. Just 3 copies of those and 4 of the Ultra Ball. I'm not sure if I said that before. And then here we have 4 copies of Level Ball. It's search your deck for a Pokemon 90 HP or less, reveal it, and put it in your hand, shuffle afterward. The reason I run the level ball is because every Pokemon in this deck has either 90 HP or less. So, you know, if you start getting hit by a super hard-hitting EX, you're not going to do too well. But, you know, if you're doing... It just depends. I have done really well with this deck, and I have done really poorly with this deck. I also run 4 copies of Puzzle of Time, if you don't know what it does. If you play one card, look at the top 3 cards of your deck and put them back in any order. Or play 2 and you can get 2 cards from your discard pile into your hand. Which is pretty cool. You know, if you're really in desperate need of drawing a double colorless energy or something, you just go ahead and use one of them. And to get your hand, or to get the card that you need next, hopefully it's a double colorless you can get. We also have 2 copies of Energy Recycler. It's shuffle 5 basic energy from your discard into your deck. I'll show you why that is necessary in just a minute. And that is all of the item cards. We're now going to move on to supporters. We have 3 copies of N. Each player shuffles his or her hand into their deck and then draws for the amount of prizes you have. It's pretty much a standard in every deck. We have 3 copies of Lysander. Again, pretty much just a standard. We have only 2 Sycamores. Normally people run 3 or 4, but I think only 2 is necessary in this deck. Discard your hand and draw 7. And then we have 1 Bridget. And what it does is you search your deck for 1 basic EX or 3 basic Pokemon and put them directly onto your bench. And since I don't run any EXs, you can get 3 basics that way. You know, if you've already got all the combis you need set up, you can go ahead and start getting the, you can put unknowns onto the bench, start powering up that B Revenge. And that is all of the supporters. Then next, we have 3 copies of Forested Giant Plants. You can evolve a grass Pokemon on the turn that they are played. And now we move on to the energy. 4 copies of Double Colorless, because the B Revenge only needs Double Colorless. And then 4 grass energies. And that is the whole deck, boys and girls. So we are going to go ahead, pick all of this back up, and then we are going to move into the Sun and Moon pre-release deck that I just played with not even an hour ago. I just got back from the Sun and Moon pre-release. It was a great time, so fun. You get to not only play your favorite game, but play your favorite game with people that also love Pokemon. So essentially, in this pre-release kit, what you got was you got a 22 cards, and they were other evolution chains, like, you know, like Zubat, Golbat, Crobat. I actually have that right here. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that these are the new look of the Sun and Moon cards. But this Crobat, look at its attack. Triple poison for 1 psychic. Your opponent's active Pokemon is now poisoned. Put 3 damage counters on that Pokemon between turns. So in just a couple of turns, any fairly strong Pokemon gets knocked out. And some other cool cards I got. I pulled this out of one of the packs. A Vikavolt Holo. Strong charge is a crazy ability. Once during your turn, you may search your deck for a grass and a lightning energy and attach them to your Pokemon in any way you like. That is crazy. And then just one of the rares I pulled, Palosand, a Wall of Sand, does 20 less damage. And then a reverse rare, Sharpedo. I love the way these reverses look. You can see in the back, it has the energy typing symbol. And now, I'm going to go ahead and show you the deck that I used today for this 3-round tournament. And this kind of tournament is different. It's a 40-card deck, and only 4 prize cards. So here we have Chinchou, nothing crazy, and Lantern. I liked this because it has Aqua Spark. If this Pokemon has any water energy attached to it, this does 60 more damage. This card is what actually won me my 3rd round. I went 2-1 today. I won round 1, lost round 2, and then won round 3. So then also we have 2 copies of this Shellder here. and two copies of Cloyster. I got these out of that the evolution pack, the just a set of cards that you can use in the deck. And then here I have a Dewpider. Nothing crazy there, but I liked it because of Araquanid's ability, Water Bubble. It prevents all damage done to this Pokemon by fire-type attacks, which could be really good in the standard format, but not in this pre-release tournament, because there really is only like one prominent fire-type, and it's Incineroar GX, and I don't think anyone at my pre-release got that card. And then also, in each pre-release kit, you get a Sun and Moon promo with a little Sun and Moon on here. You could either get Oranguru, Passimian, Bruxish, or Sheenotic. The Sheenotic card is absolutely fantastic. I hope we pull it in one of these, one of those three packs that we have for the end, because its ability is amazing. But this Oranguru has Instruct. Once during your turn, you may draw cards until you have three in your hand. It's kind of like a baby... like a baby Octillery. And then here I have Stuffle and Beware. I just picked them because it's an evolution line that I had, and it's colorless, and also, yeah, that's about it. I don't think I ever attacked with Stuffle or Beware. Here we have Pukumuku. This ability enters out. When it's knocked out, opposing Pokemon takes 6 damage counters. This helped me. This definitely helped me win that game 3. And Continuous Tumble, I actually used to knock out one or two Pokemon just because I had nothing else. It was crazy. This Corsola here, it's nice in reverse. I love the way. Just look at it. You can see all the little energies in the background. Anyway, call for family. Two basic Pokemon from your deck and put them on your bench. I needed to use this. This was like my go-to turn one Pokemon, just so I could get some basics out. And then here we have Alolan Rattata and Raticate. I never used Raticate, but I did use Rattata. Because let me show you guys something. Let me see if I can get it up close here. You can see that, and it looks different than these energies. It's because this attack is a free attack. You need no energy to use that attack. It is absolutely wild. I believe each Alolan Pokemon has a free attack. And then here we have one copy of Energy Evolution Eevee. I pulled this out of one of the packs. Energy Evolution, when you attach a basic energy from your hand to this Pokemon during your turn, you may search your deck for a card that evolves from this Pokemon that is the same type as the energy card you put onto this Pokemon, and then evolve it. So, I got this. I pulled this out of the very first of 4 packs that I opened, that Umbreon GX. It is my very first GX Pokemon. And it's GX attack. Discard 2 energy from your opponent's Pokemon. It's definitely not the best GX attack, but I did use it a couple times just because I was desperate and I needed to get rid of the opponent's energy. And that is all the Pokemon. It's a lot of Pokemon because I didn't have a whole lot of trainers. I just didn't get many out of the packs. We have 2 copies of a Timer Ball that I used today. Flip 2 coins for each head, search your deck for an evolution Pokemon and put it into your hand. Nothing too crazy there. We have a Nest Ball, search your deck for a basic energy, put it onto the bench. A Pokeball, again, I just needed to fill my deck because I didn't have really anything else to go in there. You guys know what Pokeball does. We also have a Great Ball. You guys know what that does. We have a Repel. This is like, it's kind of like a baby Lysander. It allows the opponent to pick which Pokemon they put as their active. Scoot those up there a little bit. And then we have 2 copies of Professor Kukui. It's like Giovanni's Scheme, but both of the possibilities is draw 2 cards, and then you also get 20 more damage in the attack that you do that turn. Then we also have 2 copies of Howe. It's just like Tierno, draw 3 cards. And then we have all of this energy. The Darkness energy, obviously, for Eevee. Umbreon, and the water energy for Pukumuku and Lantern to power up that Aqua Spark, and the electric energy also for Lantern. And that is my whole deck from today's pre-release. Actually, you know, I'm just going to kind of put all this together and get it off the camera, because that's not really what you guys came here for. You guys are here for these beautiful, beautiful base set Sun and Moon packs. So you know what? Let's go ahead and rub them, get all the good lucks, and we'll get cracking right into these. Oh man, they are just ripping apart. Ripping apart. And now there are code cards in these packs, but they are not active yet. Not until the actual set comes out. And there is a new pack trick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. It's 4 and then 2. Because there are 11 cards in each pack, you get a basic energy in every pack guaranteed. So here we have a Pharaoh. Let me bring it a little closer so you guys can see that. We have a Grubbin. I'm just going to kind of pause so we can look at each one, because I haven't even seen some of these. We have a Drowsy, a Crabrawler, Sandile, a basic fire energy. I love the way these basic energies look. I absolutely love it. That's going to go in a different pile because because you get a basic energy in each pack. So we don't want those all mixed in, just for my OCD purposes. We have an Alolan Raticate. You saw that in my deck. We have a Wishy-Washy, all right. An Energy Retrieval, just normal Energy Retrieval. A Reverse Holo Breon. Oh my god! 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 Whoo! I need to calm down. Oh my god. Okay, hold on. Let me get a sleeve out right now. This, my friends, I need to be super careful with this. This, my friends, is a Lurantis GX. And it's not just a regular GX. It is a hyper rare GX. Yes, I said it. You remember how the Umbreon GX looked? It just kind of looked like a normal, you know, EX kind of almost full art card. There are three varieties of GXs. There are the regular ones, like the Umbreon I got, then there are full art GXs, and then there are hyper rare GXs, which are like this and rainbowy. This is a Lurantis GX. I'm literally shaking right now. I don't know if you can see it, but I am shaking. Oh my god, this is, I can't. We still have two packs. We still have two whole packs. Let me get that reverse out of that set. Oh my goodness, we still have two packs. I don't know what to say. I've got garbage all over the place, but that's fine. Let me open this out of the camera just because it'll take too long without it. All right, and of course the new pack trick, 4 and 2. Okay. Here we go. We have an Alolan Meowth. Picky Peck. We have an Eevee. This is going into a different pile because that Eevee between the Umbreon GX and the Espeon GX is going to be an amazing card. We have a Psyduck, Spearow, a Water Energy. Love the energies. A Crushing Hammer. All right. Torracat. We have an Energy Switch. A Reverse Holo Rainbow Energy. I like the way that looks. I love that. And our rare is a Butterfree. This Butterfree actually saw some play today at the pre-release. Did pretty well, I think. All right, we're going to go ahead, rub this very last Primarina pack. Let's go ahead and do this. This one is kind of cooperating, but not really. Let's see if I can get this out without damaging anything. Because if there is a GX in this pack and I mess it up, I will cry. I will cry. I'll probably, you know, stop recording and then cry, but still. All right, we have a Crabrawler. Sandile. And then another Alolan Meowth. We have a Picky Peck. Eevee, yes, I love you, Eevee. We have a Grass Energy. a Karakarok, a Raquanid. Araquanid could be good. It just depends on how things play out. We have an EXP share, a reverse Pinsir, and our last rare of this pre-release is a holographic Toxapex. Okay. It's got a cool ability. Whenever your opponent's active Pokemon retreats, the new Pokemon is poisoned. So there we go. Our second holographic of this Sun and Moon base set. And the set hasn't even come out, and we've already got two holographics, an Umbreon GX that is amidst the mess, and this Lurantis GX. Oh my goodness, I can't believe we pulled a hyper rare. Look at it, 150 of 149. It's like a secret rare, but it's called a hyper rare. That's just what it's called now. I don't know why. This Pokemon, this card is my prized possession. This is my new prized possession. And do not forget that as soon as this set comes out on February 3rd, whenever my booster box of Sun and Moon comes in the mail, you guys will know, because it will be lit. Hopefully we can get a ton more of those. Maybe a secret rare Ultra Ball even. That would be amazing. But be sure to smash those thumbs up down below, subscribe so you don't miss out on any more Sun and Moon Pokemon TCG content. And you know what? I'm gonna get out of here, guys. Peace.